Welcome back to the Schmodown Runback. Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Sober Ryu again. Thanks for tuning in for these commentaries on the Movie Trivia Schmodown. I dimmed the lights, man. I wanted to be soft and sensual for the next part here. We're winding down. We got the second half of the 35 man free for all tournament for the Schmodown. For the first of its kind, really. It's a throwdown between 35 competitors in a Royal Rumble kind of format, and it's been awesome so far. We left on quite the cliffhanger, so they knew when to break up this video. Just to let you guys know, A, there's a part one to this that you want to watch, and you don't want to watch my part one until you watch the real part one. So you're going to find a link down below for part one and part two, which corresponds with this video. And then when you watch them both, come back and watch my commentaries. It's important you watch the original videos first because we want to make sure they get the actual views that they need in order to keep the show going. Also, it helps a lot to be able to subscribe and for Collider Video, which the link is down below, as well as on the screen right there, youtube.com/Collider Videos. If you subscribe there and check out the Schmodown when they enter, when they appear, usually on Tuesdays and Fridays every week, you're able to go ahead and be able to help out the show. If you rate and comment, what it does is it helps to the show to trend, and then other people get exposed to it and be able to check out the show too, because YouTube is screwed up. And it's really hard for a show or a channel out there to make it nowadays, and I want to see this game show continue. I want to see Collider Videos continue on, because it's been a source of entertainment for me for the last couple of years, ever since 2000, not so much Collider Video, but back when Movie Talk was on AMC, back in 2011, when I was introduced to the show, thanks to a friend of mine. And I want to see that this show continues, whatever form it's going to be in, whether it be Movie Talk, whether it be a Schmodown, whether it be Schmoes Know on their own channel with their reviews at youtube.com/Schmoes Know as well. Go there, subscribe, rate, and comment on their videos too. But for the Schmodown especially, I don't want these videos to work as some kind of substitute for actually watching the real thing. So watch the real thing first without my interruptions, and then come back and watch my actual first reactions to these episodes. And hope you guys enjoy them twice over. I know it's a lot of work, especially with as much content as they've been putting out for the Schmodown as of recently. But definitely do that, man. It's worth your time, and I hope you guys dig checking out my reactions in just a few minutes. Matter of fact, I shouldn't keep you guys waiting. We should definitely get this on. So again, down below is the link. Pause this video, come back when you're finished. And in the meantime, let's get it popping. Let's do it! My name is Sober Ryu, by the way, for Shinjuku Station. If this is your first time seeing one of our videos, subscribe to our channel if you like what you see. In the meantime, let's get it going! On one. You're gonna pause it on one if you're synchronizing the actual original video with this one. Here we go. 3, 2, one. The free-for-all, baby. We got him. Let's go. Oh, shit. Let me turn this down some. Oh, look at Bibbs. Let me turn my attention to the actual TV screen. Yeah! Let's go! Outlaw Nation is hyped today. It's been a day or two since I watched the first half. Easter Sunday came and smacked me in the face. So thanks to that, I haven't been able to watch the second half or today's episode that dropped. I'm taping this on a Tuesday, where a new episode, a team battle, just dropped for Machinima ETC versus Wolves of Steel. Wolves of Steel's gonna murder him, by the way. It's science.
It's fucking science.
Come on. And we're back. If Machinima wins that, man, like I mentioned in Christian's tweet when he posted up who was going to win, let's get going. I'll have to shave my head and go to sleep, bro. You just have to do that. 18. Oh, shit. Oh, I know that. Oh, fucking theme. No. Representing speaking of which. Aronauts was correct. They need to put this in Transformers movies every time they. Oh, Lord! Yo, look at this guy, yo. Fingering him deep. or not said in their videos, this needs to be in Michael Bay's movies when explosions happen. Oh shit!
The Four Horsemen.
Yo, the classic right here.
He has a record of
who could it be?
Oh. He is William the Beast.
The Beast. The Beast. Yo, look at this guy. Yo, that dirty ass jumpsuit. I see you. Bloody as fuck. So the man brought. Man brought equipment.
One second, I want to get comfortable here.
Oh, Jesus. Yo, my man got props. Newberry, if you just gave a fuck about your playstyle.
This is an efficient use of time.
Take notes, bro. That's how he does. Yo, he got his little tree.
Alright, get back.
You cocky. Sit down, you cocky shit.
Nah, man, he's got his shit, man. Let him get his tchotchkes out, man. Channel his powers.
And look at Elliot Dewberry, who has faced the Beast before.
Oh, he sure has, man. Got his ass whipped.
If we could compete today,
let's not talk about that.
As Bill Burr says, whipped!
Finally.
All right, here we go.
Okay, gentlemen, again.
Let's go.
Once again, the scoreboards have been reset to zero. And your first question of this round comes
let's do
you
it.
From the category of classics.
Oh, shit, already out the gate.
What movie did Elvis Presley first appear in?
Fuck.
I'm gonna be impressed if these guys pull it off.
Look
some
at
of these people
the
put us up.
That are up
this is what you hoped.
I'm gonna say Blue Hawaii. That's what it is.
Three, two, one. All right.
I can't think of too many of his movies, but
Love Me Tender.
Correct.
Oh shit!
I said Blue Hawaii.
Incorrect.
Oh, I also said Blue Hawaii.
Correct.
Oh, wow. I had Jailhouse Rock.
Incorrect. Oh, and then we had Rachel.
I said Blue Hawaii.
God damn! Yo, Roka with the snipe.
Elvis.
All right. Good shit. Good shit.
Champion getting a point here.
My boy. Let's go. Let's go.
Comic book movies. Who played Gambit in X-Men Origins Wolverine?
The charismatic Taylor Kitsch, and by charismatic I mean not. Actually, I liked him despite how bad
that. That was probably the most popular of the Logan and Wolverine.
Yeah, absolutely.
Five, four,
as bad as True Detective season two was, I did like him in it.
And Dan,
Hollywood's Charlie Brown, Taylor Kitsch.
No kidding.
I was gonna write John from Mars because I couldn't think of his name.
And
Taylor Kitsch.
Correct.
John from Mars.
Taylor Kitsch.
Correct. And Roka.
Nope.
Nothing. All
nothing.
Right.
Wow. Look at that.
Look at that. All right.
Terrible movie. Only seen it once.
Next category.
Only seen it once.
All right, guys. Now we move on to the category of sci-fi films. Who played Guy / Crewman number
come
six
on, stud.
In Galaxy Quest.
Yo, Sam Rockwell. Sam motherfucking Rockwell. Make sure to put the motherfucking.
One of the greatest sci-fi / comedies ever.
Oh,
made.
God.
Fucking classic.
And five, four, three, two, one. Pence down. Elliot.
Tony Shalhoub.
No. Incorrect. No, close, but no cigar, bro.
By Grabthar's hammer, it was Sam Rockwell.
Thank
it
you.
It was indeed.
All right, Rachel.
Nothing.
Roka.
Damn.
Sam Rockwell.
Correct. Thank you, sir.
Sam Rockwell.
You oh, Rachel, you haven't seen Galaxy Quest? You gotta change that. She may have seen it, but let me not assume.
Dewberry has to get on the board in
this
round.
Boy, Ken with the Robotech representation.
Next category of thriller. Name the movie from the synopsis. A lawyer becomes a target by a corrupt politician and his NSA goons when he accidentally receives key evidence to a serious politically motivated crime.
It's the only movie I've ever seen the Turbo Express ever be integrated into the plot. It was Enemy of the State. Turbo fucking Express. Little handheld device that was a TurboGrafx-16. They put like some secrets into that shit.
That's correct.
Thank you, sir.
With Parallax View.
Incorrect, Roka.
Enemy of the State.
Correct.
That's a good pick, though.
Enemy of the State.
Correct, Elliot.
Ides of March.
Get the fuck out of here.
All right, so, and last question here.
All right, Dewberry and Cushing.
Woo, let's go.
Here. We move on, folks, to your final
on,
question
Rachel.
In this round.
Don't get dragged down by this guy.
The category
please.
Of directors. Who directed the film Straight Outta Compton?
Oh, my God. His name has been in the news recently. F. Gary Gray, director of F8, man. Furious 8, man.
The
fate
will
of the Furious.
To the next round.
Five, four, three.
Man, you don't know?
Two.
Oh, bro, come on.
And Rachel.
Is it John Singleton?
No.
Incorrect.
Correct. Roka.
I don't know. I put Antoine Fuqua.
No.
Incorrect.
F. Gary Gray.
Thank you, Dan. Jesus.
F. Gary Gray.
Correct.
F. Gary Gray.
Correct.
Correct.
All right. Well, the
director of motherfucking Friday. Come on, man. Step it up.
Cushing have been eliminated.
That sucks. I really want to see Rachel go far, man. That fucking sucks.
What a table. That table.
Dewberry, you had to drag her down, huh? You actually knew an answer. Amazing.
There we go. All right, so now Bibiani.
Shout out to Dewberry though. Burl, he makes me laugh. Roca.
We can awful. Just stay here. We don't need anybody else.
Oh, yeah.
Oh no, no, McWeenie.
Don't get too comfortable,
look at
man.
This table.
You could be fucked
right now.
Number 20.
Where's Levine when you need him?
Number 20.
Ooh, Sam? That guy's all showing no substance. In this game. In this game. Oh, yo, Bernard. My son has arrived. Yes. Yes, let's go. Let's go. Look at my boy. It was good to see you, Mark, man. God damn. We still got brothers in this mix.
And the number 21.
Yo, this remix, though. What's Funk Master Flex?
TV Talk.
Oh.
He is making his debut. Oh. David.
Yo, Griffin? I thought it was going to be Makuga, but he'd have his own music, though. Yo, look at that beautiful beard. Yo, this must be before he murdered it. Yo, big day, man. Yo, I love to see some David Griffin in this.
That's right
this. Out of all his premiere, the son. There, this is the one
yo, this brother had to get broken in at a table of killers.
What a way to come into it.
All right,
no
guys,
fucking kidding. No doubt, man.
In the category of Pixar films.
Woo, all right.
Who sang the song You've Got a Friend in Me from Toy Story?
Yo, Randy motherfucking Newman.
Who sang that song?
Make sure to put in the motherfucking.
I don't have a lot of friends to sing that to, but you could do
sing,
it.
You can always sing that to me.
Okay. All right.
Damn, Ken, man.
Good with that. Five.
Ken needs
four,
a friend at the end of the world,
three,
right?
Two, one, hands down and Roca.
Randy Newman?
Correct.
Thank you, sir.
Dan.
Randy Newman.
That's correct. What I'm talking about.
Newman? Correct.
Yo, Newman.
Ah, scores and soundtracks. Randy Newman?
Correct.
Question mark.
Oh, come on, Dan. Dan.
Right. So David finding himself
sorry,
a little
David?
Bit in the hole to start things off.
Dan. Right. Call him Dan Moore. Yeah. Fix my face.
All right, guys, we move on.
Come on,
to
David.
The next
that was a slam dunk.
Comes to you from the category of Indiana Jones films.
Oh, oh shit.
There you go.
I love Indian movies.
What
but...
was the name of Indy's arch rival and main villain of Raiders of the Lost Ark?
Man, I don't fucking know. I don't know at all.
See it in their
you're like, for some reason, I don't remember details from Indy except for the plot points. And Indy himself and his name. And what's the name of his boy?
Merle. Ivan Ooze himself, Belloc.
Wow, I totally forgot, man. Ivan Ooze?
Correct.
Belloc, huh?
Ah, couldn't bring it.
Couldn't get it. David.
Didn't know.
Roca.
Damn, David.
Moloch?
Incorrect.
Oh, man.
That's what his friends called him. That's what his
friends
called
him. Well, Eli Wallach, man.
Bernard,
how about that?
Correct. All right, in next category of Kubrick.
That was a tough
Kubrick
one.
Films.
For me, anyway.
The 1957 Kubrick film Paths of Glory stars what American actor as
shit.
Colonel Dax?
I need to bone up on my classics, man.
Guys writing furiously
shit.
At this point.
Yeah. This is, you look at these guys. These are hungry dudes right
any
now.
Any mistake.
Let me say,
I'm going to
just go with Peter's,
four,
Peter.
Three.
What is it? Peter, two, Peter
one,
Sellers.
Mark.
Kirk Douglas.
Correct.
Nope.
Beast.
Kirk Douglas.
Correct, David.
I'm dead ass wrong.
No.
All right, John.
Kirk Douglas.
But David, just get one.
Kirk Douglas.
Just get one, my brother. Just
all right, guys,
one.
In the category
we got two brothers at the
of
table.
Denzel
come on.
Washington.
Oh, yo, Denzel? Oh,
which
shit.
Which basketball star played Jesus Shuttlesworth in He Got Game?
I don't remember.
I don't have game when it comes to basketball.
Can't suffer from severe lack of game.
Three, two, one, beast.
That one guy.
Incorrect.
No, nope, incorrect, bro.
Ray Allen.
Correct.
So, I know he knows basketball.
Roca.
And so
Ray
does
Allen,
he.
Correct.
Yeah. Yo, upside down, though.
Ray Allen.
Correct.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
Correct. And Mark.
Ray Allen.
Correct.
That's
correct.
What's happening.
Go. Okay.
God damn it. NBA champs at the
this.
Table.
If Griffin can get this right and the Beast misses, then they both will be eliminated. Oh, my goodness. Here we go. This is
here
big.
We go.
In the category of musicals. David Griffin now just really fighting to eliminate the Beast. And musicals. Who played Satine in 2001's Moulin Rouge?
I fucking know this. Satine? It's Nicole Kidman.
I cried during that movie.
Nicole Kidman. I've seen a piece of that movie.
Five,
I haven't sat through the whole
four,
thing. I'm sure it's great.
Three,
my brother
two,
loves it, though.
One, David Griffin. What do you got?
Nicole Kidman.
Correct.
Kidman.
Hey, good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff.
Nicole Kidman.
Correct. Yeah. Merle.
Correct. It's like Roca never knows what they're going to call
Nicky
him.
Nicky Keezy.
All right, this is the big one.
Nicky Keezy.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
Oh,
jeez.
Wow,
yo,
David, when you went out strong,
Griffin.
Baby, you went out strong. I see you. I see you. R.I.P. Beard. R.I.P. Beard, man. Grow it back, bro. Grow it back, bro.
All right.
All right.
I need to see the Teddy Pendergrass again, bro.
22.
You grow it so well. I wish I could grow a beard that fucking pimping. Oh, shit, McWeenie?
Look at the record of two wins.
go, man. We got a table full of fucking murderers. Holy shit, look at this pimp. I see you. And he brought his kids. He brought his kids. He's got to win, son. Yo, McWayne. Oh, he had to wipe the nervous sweat off his palm. God, we got a murderer's row.
No,
this is hype as shit.
You jealous?
That is.
Let's do this.
Take pictures of that.
But no matter how good this table
God,
is,
God, this may never happen again.
One of them are getting eliminated at the end
let's
of
go,
this
let's
round.
Go.
All right, here we go, John. You're up.
All right, folks.
Yes,
your first question.
Nothing going in.
About that, I would have kept it right side up. I'm just saying.
Oh, oh Dan.
I guess your first question.
Mess with a good thing.
Yeah, you know what? Keep it popping.
Shut up.
Sorry, John.
Good luck.
First question in this brand new round.
All right.
Comes to you from the category of Christopher Nolan.
I gotta say, it's a nice touch to have the questions
what
on the screen.
Christopher Nolan movie received an Oscar nomination for Best Picture?
That would be Inception. That would be Inception. It wasn't Interstellar, and it wasn't The Dark Knight. Definitely fucking wasn't The Dark Knight. I don't think it was any of his earlier work either.
And five.
Pretty sure it's Inception. That turned a lot of heads that year.
Three. Two.
I think it was 2010? 2009?
Correct. Merle.
Inception.
Correct. Mark.
Inception.
Correct.
Thank you.
Wah, Inception.
Correct.
Wah.
Oh, everyone gets
Wah.
It. All
Yo, goddamn, right. Boy. It's a home run derby, back. Son.
Next category. Next category of movie quotes. Name the sci-fi film with the following quote. So long, and thanks for all the fish.
That would be...
I got a feeling we're going to see this one.
Fuck, that is... That's Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, man. Another Sam Rockwell joint, man.
This is not an all-star table. This is a Hall of Fame
yes.
table.
Five,
it kind of is.
Four, three, two, one. Merle.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Correct.
Thank you, Dan.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Correct. Thank you, Mark.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the
Correct.
Galaxy.
McWeeny.
Thank you, Bibbs.
The Hitchhiker's Guide.
Roka. Yes.
Thank you, McWeeny.
The Thing.
Oh, no. 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 Come on, man. You broke the flow. Right.
You read good books, though, right?
Damn.
All right, guys. Your next question.
Yeah, that excuse ain't going to fly, Roka, man. I'm counting
films.
On you, bro. You got to watch shitty movies, too, man.
What is the name
this
of
isn't
the
good movie
that the team runs at the end of Little Giants?
I don't fucking
True
know.
True Little Giants filmed in my hometown of Royal
Screw
Grande, California.
Screw you.
Yo, these questions. This has got to be an Ellis four, question. Three, it's either Ellis or McCoonan that wrote this.
One,
come on, son.
Dan Merle.
The touchdown play.
Incorrect.
Nope.
Correct.
All right, Bernardin.
The Aristocrats.
Will anyone get this right?
Statue of Liberty play.
Incorrect.
Sweeney. True.
The Rusty Trombone?
I wish. I fucking
Incorrect.
Wish.
Roka?
Flea Flicker?
And the crowd gets it. The annexation of Puerto Rico is the play we were looking for.
Okay, wow. All right, so nobody.
I was confused.
Was that two people in the audience knew?
Next category of Harry Potter films.
Oh, here we go.
What? No, I don't read the book. I don't. What British character actor appears as Peter Pettigrew in the Harry Potter series?
Shit, I know his
Which
face.
Which British character actor appears as Peter
oh,
Pettigrew
fuck.
In the Harry Potter series?
A lot of
God damn it.
Actors to choose from.
He played in a movie that got nominated right. for something. I think five, he got nominated recently.
Four,
older English
three,
actor, but all of them
two,
are. Fuck.
One and Mark Bernardin.
I'm gonna kick my own
I got
ass.
It wrong. I know. David Phyllis.
Incorrect. No. Bibbiani.
Timothy Spall.
Correct.
Yes, that's it.
Timothy Spall.
Correct.
Thank
Roka.
You.
Timothy Spall.
Correct.
Good shit. Good
and
shit.
Merle.
Didn't have it.
Wow. Peter.
Wow.
He got Peter, man.
Three, two, two,
Peter,
two.
Man.
All right.
Yo, what is his office space?
This just got fun.
All right, guys. Fifth
God
question.
Damn, this is...
Anything can happen scenario, guys. Your
anything
fifth
goes.
And final question.
Oh
of this
shit,
round
we might lose three
comes
or
from the category
or four of them.
Of Will Smith films.
Oh, boy.
Woo.
Oh dear.
We already had one so far.
As Josh McCouga laughs in heaven in Bad Boys. What happens to Marcus when he's around dead bodies?
He throws up. He gets sick. Nauseous, whatever the fuck you want to call it. But he throws up.
This would have been the only
this table.
Question. Yeah.
Four, three, two.
Everybody
one.
Might get this. I don't know.
Now, to clarify, this Bad Boy is the original, not the sequel.
Yeah.
Yes. Correct.
Okay, so I think throws up.
Correct.
Correct.
He starts to throw up.
Merle.
Correct.
I put he vomits, but I said thanks for all the fish just in case.
Yo, Dan. Cool as ice.
Oh, yeah,
oh no, Mark.
I gets nauseous, but that's.
Yeah, that
you know,
should be allowed.
Throw up, right?
Yeah, yeah, please.
I would take that.
No, you should take it. He gets nauseous. Throwing up is just a symptom of getting nauseous. Come on now.
We're going to make a call, and we will take that.
Yeah, okay. What the fuck?
And after that, the magic man, Mark Bernardin, has shit.
Unbelievable.
Wow.
What a great round.
Damn, Mark, man. It's good to see you, though, bro. Good to see you. There's no brothers left. Damn.
Your next competitor, shit. Number 23.
Oh, shit. Yo, Genuine?
Kinda Funny. Nick, the producer slash seducer. Nick Scarpino.
We're about to turn this dude out. This guy's at Hogan's Alley about to be shot. Like, who are you trying to seduce? Dudes? Go on, man.
Yeah, this is not intimidating at all.
Do it.
No, it's fine. I got this. You're fine.
All right.
Oh, good. The chairs roll so I can roll
on
it.
Here we go. In the category of holiday films.
Yo, real talk?
Who played Santa Claus in the movie Elf?
Oh, that would be Ed Asner.
Santa Claus in the movie
Yo, my boy Lou Grant? I fucking love that guy.
Now, Santa Claus
Ed Wetzler?
Not, right?
Not proven.
Oh, okay. The fucking legend is who played him. Ed motherfucking Asner. Come on, everybody should get this shit.
No, I'm joking. Ed Asner.
Thank you, sir.
Damn it.
Ed Asner.
I'm proud of you.
I got this wrong. Apologies, Yamati.
How in the fuck?
Fred Sloan. Sing of the wrong character, Bob Newhart.
No, Bob Newhart played his mentor.
Wow, okay, so look at that. That was big.
Damn.
Okay.
All right, guys, we move on now to the category of dramas.
Mm.
Which movie starred Haley Joel Osment, Michael Caine, and Robert Duvall as bored rich farmers?
So rich. It's Secondhand Lions. I've seen the trailer. I've never seen the movie, but... It's not that many movies that have Haley Joel Osment in it, and I remember that when that movie got advertised. Such a weird title, too. Secondhand motherfucking Lions.
My great uncle's favorite movie, Secondhand Lions.
God damn, of all the fucking films?
I put On Golden Pond.
Bibiani. Tim McKinley's very underrated Secondhand Lions.
Correct.
Secondhand Lions.
This guy's all right.
There you go.
Woo! Look at this, man.
Take a break. I got this next one.
Yeah. Okay. All right, here we go. Next question in the category of Tim Burton films.
Woo.
Who composed the score for Pee-wee's Big Adventure?
Only one man could have done this, man. Come on, yo, Danny motherfucking Elfman. Oingo, motherfucking Boingo. Danny Elfman.
He used to be afraid of bikes.
Five, yes. Four,
oh, indeed.
Three, two, one. Nick.
Danny Elfman?
Correct.
Thank you, bro.
Danny Elfman?
Correct.
Leave with a point, at least.
I get punched if I didn't know this.
Yes. That's what I'm saying. Your kids will punch you.
Broken.
Oh, Danny Elfman.
Correct.
Second time's a charm.
They keep shocking Roker.
All right, there you go. Okay, next
his right, reactions.
Guys, we move on to the category of 80s films.
Shout out to the Outlaw, man.
What name did Marty use as an alias in Back to the Future 3?
That would be Clint Eastwood, son. The legend.
The three.
Clint. Oh, my God. Please tell me y'all know this. That should be one of the most watched trilogies of all time, like next to the Star Wars trilogy.
Oh, man,
you don't know
Mr. Eastwood.
Two plus in the Old West.
Andrew.
Clint Eastwood.
Correct.
Ah, Billy the Kid.
No!
Oh. Clint Eastwood.
Thank you.
Nick.
Clint Eastwood.
Correct. Okay, there you go.
So good. Come on, Broker, man. So don't get washed.
The last
don't get washed, bro.
Here, and I can't
Outlaw Nation is counting on you, bro.
For this one.
Come on.
In the category of who said it.
Oh, fuck.
What actor famously said, here's looking at you, kid.
Yo, a million people said that, but Humphrey Bogart. Come on. Come on, dude. Yo,
three,
bogey, son.
Two,
come on.
One, Drew.
Bogey.
Thank you.
Humphrey Bogart.
All right, there you go. Roka.
Humphrey Bogart.
I know Roka knows
Humphrey
this shit.
Humphrey Bogart.
Humphrey freaking Bogart.
And
thank you.
Angry. No, it's Humphrey Bogart.
We're on a perfect round there. So did McQueenie. And there you have Nick Scarpino has
good
been
shit.
Eliminated.
You know what?
Yo, Nick came through at the end. I gotta say, he went out with his head up.
This match,
who's next?
3 points got eliminated.
Good stuff.
Nick had 3 points. It's just look at the 3 points.
Merle would have got you through a few rounds, but not now.
Well, Dan is exhausted. He's been up here for a while.
Opponent number
forget what number he was when it came out.
Into the Assassin's Den. He is representing E.T.
Oh, man. Come on, Ricky.
Ricky.
Ricky, don't get too comfortable, bro. let's go.
Look at their shots. Look at them.
Look at his murderers. I know, right? They might be just the four of them and whoever's sitting in that hot seat. Because that's what it is.
Can I get an easier group of people to beat?
Oh, jeez. All right, guys.
Sorry,
once again,
bro.
The scoreboards have been reset.
Time to
and
beef
we start
up.
Off this round. Fittingly, under the category of Ooh. Oscars.
Oh, yo, already? Out the gate, yo.
In 1939, The Wizard of Oz lost the Academy Award for Best Picture to what film?
Gone with the Wind, son.
That is,
Gone with the Wind.
It is crazy to think of The Wizard of Oz as classic.
I don't think it's Mr. Smith Goes to Washington, because I think that came out the same year, but it's definitely Gone with the Wind. That movie swept the Oscars, if I recall.
I don't know. Gone with the Wind?
That's correct.
Jeez. Oh, yo, shit, man. Just tripping right into that. Hey, yo, Ricky? All right.
And I had How Green Is My Valley.
Oh, no. That's the 40s, bro. Goddamn. Nice pull, though. I see.
Not green enough. I'm beating you.
How green is my wrong answer?
Look at him.
Christopher Nolan film.
Again.
Go. Damn. He's popular as fuck.
What actor has trouble sleeping in insomnia?
That'd be Al Pacino.
Which actor has problems sleeping
in insomnia? Al fucking Pacino.
Trouble sleeping.
It's a well-titled movie.
Five.
That's an awesome movie, four, man. I saw it in the theaters back when
two,
it came out.
One, Merle.
Hooah!
Hooah! That's what I was looking for.
RDJ, I don't know.
Oh, RDJ, man, get out of here with that.
Al Pacino.
Correct, Drew.
Al Pacino.
And he's back on board.
Al Pacino.
Damn straight.
There you go. So now it's
Roca back in the zone, baby. Let's go.
The Beast is two, and Ricky and McQueenie tied at one. All right, next category.
You're not pouring that on my Switch. Oh, my God.
To Sandra Bullock.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
The Speed sequel could not reunite Sandra Bullock and her co-star Keanu Reeves, but what 2006 film did?
I think they mentioned it earlier. It's The Lake House. You know, you may stumble across some answers earlier on. If you pay attention to other people's answers, you may actually get the answer you're looking for. The Lake House.
All right. Five.
It's definitely
four,
The Lake House. I remember
three,
how big a deal that was
two,
when they reunited.
Ricky.
Four Christmases.
No, problem. No.
That would be The Lake House.
That's correct. Drew, get back on top. The Drew's back house. On top with
there
that and Roca.
One of my favorites, honestly, The Lake House.
Right. Oh, shit.
No Lake House.
No bullshit.
We know our Lake House. Sure, give them the Danny Elfman question.
Roca coming lakeside, bro.
Musicals in 2012.
Coming live to your lakeside.
Jean Valjean was originally sent to jail for stealing what?
That Wonder. That Wonder bread, son. Who's jacking that bread?
Brilliant
bread
story,
is delicious.
Russell Crowe's singing voice?
Five.
It should have been.
Four. Three. Two. One, Bibiani.
No, can't make sandwiches
bread,
without it. Thank you, bro.
In its multitude.
Roca.
Bread.
Correct. Merle.
Bread.
Correct.
All right.
And Ricky.
Cell phone. No, I'm kidding. Bread.
Hey, yo, Ricky. All right, I'll see you.
Look,
good shit, Ricky. Good shit. Let's go.
Ricky could eliminate McQueenie if McQueenie misses and he hits. Here we go.
Wow.
But will it?
It'll be a mindfuck.
Yeah, we'll see. Your final question of this round will come to you
from the category. McQueenie has this question.
Of westerns.
Hey!
What was John Wayne's final film in 1976?
I don't fucking know.
What was John Wayne's final film?
I don't know.
It was 76.
I couldn't even tell. I didn't even know he did a movie in 76.
That Ricky misses.
I don't know when he did The Duke. And I know it's not True Grit.
One pens down, please.
Shit.
Drew.
I have a horrible feeling I've just done this wrong. I put Rooster Cogburn.
That's incorrect.
Rooster Cogburn.
The Shootist?
That's correct.
Oh, shit.
The Shootist.
Correct.
The Shootist.
Ricky.
Wrong actor, but Xanadu.
Oh,
no, bro. No. Nice attempt, though.
It is The Shootist.
It is The Shootist.
Look at that.
The Shootist. What a title. What a title.
Ricky has been eliminated.
Oh, fuck. Kicking mics. I'm sorry, guys.
It's an honor to go up against these men.
Hey, Ricky, you did okay. God damn, I keep banging my headphones.
Two rounds in a row with five.
That's what's up. Yo, shout out to Ricky, man. Shout out.
Three perfect rounds.
I may bag on him, but he's all right.
Introducing... You're next. Who can hang with these guys?
I will see him get murdered later on during the next episode.
25.
With his partner, Elliot. Oh,
he
man. And Draco? Oh, shit! God damn, we got a stack of murderers. Here we go. Is he going to do the spin? Oh, shit, he's blocking bullets. Oh, fuck, he did it. He did it, son. Look at that, yo. Scooping. Good shit. Let the man sit in the hot seat. I think he can handle the temperature. Think he can handle it. Damn, this guy's a machine.
This is quite a quintet.
He's the android.
All right.
Next category.
All right.
Category. And the category of Natalie Portman films.
Right. Oh, fuck.
For a role in what film did Natalie Portman shave her head?
That'd be V for Vendetta, man.
Shaved her head.
It's the best non-unofficial Wachowski siblings movie.
Better than anything
they didn't credit, get credited for directing it, but according to Christian, those motherfuckers directed that movie.
V for Vendetta.
Correct, Merle.
V for Vendetta.
That's what's up.
V for Vendetta.
Correct.
Thank you.
V for Vendetta.
I know he would know, because that's a...
Perfect round.
That's a... What's that label? It's a label connected to DC that did that comic, and he's a comic book writer, so I would expect him to know great comics like that.
Drama.
All right, here we go.
What 1999 movie features a man with a supernatural powers and a mouse named Mr. Jingles?
It's understandable, though. I'll probably have to recycle questions from here and there. But that's the Green Mile. I didn't know the answer the first time I came across that. I may have actually done a commentary on an episode already that had that question.
Green Mile.
It's the Green Mile, yeah.
Green Mile.
I only know it from there.
Green Mile.
Correct, true.
Green Mile.
I've seen the movie, but I haven't seen the movie since it came out.
One of those rounds.
Category of biopics.
I'm going to watch that in Shawshank back to back.
The Aviator showcases the many dalliances that Howard Hughes had with Hollywood leading ladies like Katherine Hepburn, Ava Gardner, and Jean Harlow. Name an actress that played one of those parts.
I only can name one of them, and it's Cate Blanchett. Cate Blanchett is the one, and the reason I remember that is because she, I think, was nominated or won for that role, if I recall.
One, Andrejka.
Cate Blanchett.
Correct. Thank you. Bibiani.
Cate Blanchett.
Drew.
Blanchett.
Rocha.
Damn straight.
Cate Blanchett, and for Sam, Kate Beckinsale,
Merle.
And Gwen Stefani.
Merle.
Damn,
I
all three.
Gwen Stefani, but I wrote Cate
That's
Blanchett.
That's fine.
All
right.
Okay.
All, so now, all again, three,
whatever
three,
works.
We could be
Rocha knew all three.
Here.
Don't challenge
me. Here we go.
All right,
don't
guys.
Don't challenge me.
We now move on to the category of Oscar films. Jerome Robbins is the only person to win an Oscar for Best Director for the only movie he ever directed. What 1960s film did he win for?
Oh, there we go.
Some of these guys already writing their answers before.
I don't fucking know, actually.
McQueenie didn't even hesitate.
Four.
Sound. No, that's not Sound of Music.
Two. One. Bibiani.
Fuck.
Tom Jones?
Incorrect. Correct. Drew.
West Side Story.
Correct.
Oh, wow.
West Side Story.
Correct.
Wow. West Side Story.
Wow.
I should know the Rooker would know that.
West Side Story.
Of course he'd know. Stereotypes.
Wow, Bibiani now on the verge of going out.
Yo, the Bibs? Oh, no. It's one of my
Scarlett
fucking favorites.
Johansson
Matter of fact, all my favorites to win this are at this table.
Scarlett Johansson played Samuel Jackson's evil accomplice, Silken Floss, in what 2008 film?
One of the worst fucking movies ever goddamn made, The Fucking Spirit. Fuck that movie.
Man.
I can't believe Neo and the Wonder loved that shit. I don't understand it.
Three,
it's the worst fucking
two,
film.
One, okay.
It is
we
trash.
Drew.
I sat through that bullshit.
Nothing. Yeah, nothing.
No, right, bro, no.
Nothing.
Wow. The Spectre?
That is
no.
Correct. And Andrejka.
The Spirit.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Shit.
The Spirit.
Get the fuck out of here! What? What? Oh, bullshit! No! Bibiani, look at that! Look at this asshole! Yo, Jeff! No fucking way! Yo, everybody caught a case! Yo, what? What just happened? So Bibiani got the question right, which moved up to 4 points and wiped out everybody else. That is nuts! Oh my god, guys! Yo, Mark, the fucking demon killers. He murdered him, son. Yo, Christian about to pass out.
Can I take a picture of this first?
No kidding.
Draco taking a picture.
Well, look at that empty ass table. They got to call four people.
McQueenie and the Beast.
God damn, they got washed. Yo, they got washed. I can't believe they got washed, fellas.
That, we have more competitors coming
oh,
in.
You gotta be shitting me,
coming
man.
In at number 26.
What the hell just happened?
The Urban Gladiator, Jay.
Oh, finally, yo, Jay. Jay, I'm gonna need you to hang in there, man. You gotta hang in there, bro. I need to see you get far. I forgot there was another brother in the mix, Jay. Come on, son. Do it for your America's favorite big body. I need to see you. Let me see you take it, bro.
Number 27,
do this.
Representing Team Trek.
Oh, shit. Tell me it's Scott Mance. Tell me it's Mance. Team Trek, come on. Jason Yo, tell me Mance made it, though. We haven't seen him yet. There's still hope. This table is so much different than it was 10 minutes ago. I'm about to get washed. This ain't geek knowledge. This is movie knowledge.
He's the former movie trivia showdown inner geekdom champion.
Oh, Burnett? Yo, Burnett versus Inman? All right. Let's go. Look at that beautiful ass jacket. I see you, bro. I totally forgot my boy was in there. Yo, the captain, son. I love he just brings it every fucking time, son.
Inman finally gets... Finally getting Burnett. Man, you've got to think, though, Ed Drago is coming off a high.
What an entrance.
Like a hero. Look at him. He's like a hero.
Everyone is thanking him. Everyone is thanking him.
You're welcome for
clearing
the
deck. God damn. Drago literally cleared the deck.
The competitor right now.
The fuck is this? Who is it?
6 degrees.
Oh.
Stacy.
I should have known she was going to be, because I saw her in that red dress. I was wondering if she was Jessica Rabbit, man. Good shit. She came with props. I love how Six Degrees always brings it with their presentation. What? Yo, Burnett, baby.
She's just drawn that way.
Still in shock.
Let's go.
Only four of the top possible guys to win this thing.
I know, it's nuts, man.
Zero for five in this round.
So there we go. There are.
You see me look this way. I'm looking at my Adobe Audition to make sure it's recording the audio.
So far, we'll see how he fares. As we get to this new table.
Hopefully it doesn't
All
show.
All right, guys, here we go, John.
That would suck.
All right, new table, new round, new blank boards, and we're going to start with a new question.
Wait a minute. Can I just say that in my pre-interview, I called for diversity, and I am very proud to be sitting at this table that represents incredible diversity. In the
Hell yeah.
Can you stop kissing up and let's get to this?
Yeah, yo, Jay. Jay with the renegade.
Robotech over there.
Man, bro, yeah, that's what I'm talking about, baby. Yeah. Yo, Burnett, man, another Robotech brother.
Who played Dr. Ellie Sattler in Jurassic Park?
Soon to be seen in Star Wars Episode 8. We're talking about...
I'm afraid of
that. Oh, no.
Five.
What's her name?
Four. Three.
Oh, fuck.
Two. One. Jay.
Laura Dern.
That's correct.
God damn it.
I couldn't remember her name.
Incorrect.
That's what I'm saying. I couldn't remember her name.
Correct. Robert.
I know she's in Episode 8, though.
Stacey. That's correct.
All right. God damn, Bruce Dern's daughter.
Next category.
What the fuck is wrong with me?
Coming of age. Coming
Slick,
of age.
Fellas. Sorry.
Jake Gyllenhaal and Chris Cooper star in what family film about boys in West Virginia who build rockets for a science fair?
I have seen that one, Christian.
Chris Copper, man. He's changed his name.
Pretty good about himself as that last round.
I don't know.
Five.
I know it's a bottle rocket. That's
Two, one.
That's with
Jason.
The Wilsons.
October Sky.
That's correct.
That's
Mark.
It.
October Sky.
That's correct, Robert.
October Sky.
Good shit.
Believe it or not, this says October Sky. It's really hard to write with.
All right, that's fine.
Yo, you got to take off one of those gloves.
Okay, all right. So Dave,
sorry, Mom.
All right, so.
Oh, yeah, that was real close.
Next category.
No, it's part of the costume.
All right, guys. With your boards erased, here we go. Your next category comes to you.
Sometimes you got
to
do what you got to do.
Movie quotes.
Don't let that glove fuck you up.
Name the movie in which a scientist states... But if the Pirates of the Caribbean breaks down,
there's a lot of Jurassic Park love up in this.
The tourists.
It's Jurassic Park all day. I think it was Jeff Goldblum that said that.
Five, four, three, two, one. All right, Mark.
Jurassic Park.
That's correct, Robert.
Jurassic Park.
Stacey. Jurassic Park.
Yes,
Jay.
Jurassic Park.
Correct.
Jurassic Park.
There you go. Trick, okay. Bitch.
Next category.
Haven't you seen my movies?
I know the title of the movie.
Category of 80s films. 80s films. Finish the title of this 1985 film, Desperately Seeking...
Susan, starring Madonna.
The crowd.
I don't know.
The crowd, you know? Really,
McCoy must be losing his shit right now.
Five, four,
is he here?
Three, two,
he might not be
one.
Here in this episode.
Mark.
Susan.
That's correct, Robert.
That was a slam dunk.
Susan.
Correct,
thank you,
Stacey.
Bro.
Correct,
hey,
Jay.
All right.
Susan.
Correct, Jason.
Susan.
That's correct.
All right, there we go.
Let's go.
All right, so a final question. This is the final question.
Final question, and again, anything could happen. And so, fittingly, we go to the category of rom-coms.
Oh, fuck. That's my
what is the name of the supermodel character that Grace Jones plays in the 1992 film Boomerang?
I guess you could say it's a rom-com.
Yes!
It was Strong J, if I recall.
Three, two, Strong one, Stacey.
Yeah, you you both love that movie.
Jay.
Strong J.
That's correct. Jason, no.
He's going home.
Mark.
Strong J with the X.
Unfortunately, so was
I said Sean J.
Incorrect.
Hey, man. All still right, made it,
so
though.
So after that, Jason Inman has been eliminated.
Out of here, man. Shout out to Jason Inman. We've all been doing this table.
But a nice round for all the competitors.
Good show.
Yeah, Stacey and Draco better. Scores perfectly. Everyone. All right, no. So here we go. Number
Who's next?
30.
Yo, 30, man. We're almost in the final stretch.
6 degrees.
Oh, yo, Brienne?
Brienne Chandler, Miss Moon.
There we go.
There we go.
I was wondering when she'd show up. Good stuff, good stuff. She brought the yep. Basic Instincts, son.
That is
Sharon Stone.
And can't Stacy.
She wears. She's rocking that dress for real.
6 degrees to be it.
I tell you, man. Six degrees be bringing it, man. With the presentation.
Will they take a title shot?
It's a good ass team. I hope they go far.
All right, here we go. Category of horror. Horror films.
All right.
What is the name of the pub in Shaun of the Dead?
It is the Winchester.
Somewhere the Winchester Dan Cathedral, Merle babe. Is having a fit. That is.
That, yo, Dan missed that question Dan by just a few film. Minutes. That does suck. It's his
all
favorite
right.
movie, man.
There we go.
One of his favorite. Jaws would be his favorite. Four, but Shaun of the Dead is definitely in his probably three, his top five if
two,
I was to guess.
One, Jay.
The hell if I know.
All right.
Oh, damn. Yeah. No.
The Winchester.
That's correct. Mark.
I suck. I forgot it.
Ooh. Drink it with Burnett.
The Winchester.
That's correct.
There you go, bro.
Winchester.
Wow.
So I want to see. Yo, Burnett, let's go.
Draco with his first miss.
Wow.
Let's do this.
6 degrees representing. All right, folks. We move on to your next category.
Let's see Burnett make
to
it to fucking
in the form of
Hector,
new
man.
Releases.
Wherever the hell Hector's at in this list.
What Game of Thrones star played the father in Sing Street?
Did we talk about Mayor Tommy?
What
Littlefinger?
What's his name?
Aiden Gillen, that's what his name is.
Five,
get out of here with that shit. Come on. Know your Game of Thrones, man. Step it up.
Three.
Step it up, your game.
Two, one,
it's only the
Littlefinger.
The slimiest character in Game of Thrones, baby.
Mark.
Not correct.
The guy that runs the whores, but I forget his name.
All Aiden right. Gillen, man.
Robert.
Eon, I forget.
It's not Eon Rufford.
I said Littlefinger, too.
Nice, and nobody, and Jay.
Littlefinger.
No.
Aiden Gillen.
All right. Aiden Gillen.
Aiden Gillen.
Too bad you're not in it.
Sorry.
All right, here we go.
Yeah, that Kim would have slam dunked that question.
Question number three here in the category of Tom
shit on that
Cruise
question.
Films.
Yeah.
Tom Cruise and Cuba Gooding Jr. featured star in which two movies together? Two films.
Ooh.
Which ones?
I know one of them is Jerry Maguire.
Now, the one is a bit of a gimme. The yeah. second one is going to see where the people...
I have no clue what the other one is.
And
Vanilla
five,
Sky, possibly,
four,
or...
Three, two,
oh, fuck.
One. And Draco.
Magnolia
and Tropic Thunder?
It's incorrect.
No.
Robert.
I just got Jerry Maguire.
That's incorrect. Mm.
That's the only one I got.
I said Jerry Maguire and I started to write Spice World because I thought it would be fun.
It's incorrect.
Jerry Maguire and Boat Trip.
Incorrect.
No,
Boat Trip.
Jerry Maguire and I have no idea.
Wow, we were looking for Jerry Maguire and A Few Good Men.
Oh! I don't know if Cuba Gooding Jr. is in A Few Good Men. He must have been, what, a very minor character in that
All
shit.
All right, folks, we move back to the
wow.
category
yeah, that's
of
deep
rom-coms.
Cut for real. I wouldn't say he started
the
it with
The Jane
him.
Austen novel, Emma, provides the basis for what 1990s rom-com?
This I know.
It's a couple of smirks yeah.
It's clueless.
Yeah,
it's clueless, man.
Here we go. Five.
Now, the ladies
four,
already got it, man.
Three,
the ladies already burned through that
one,
answer fast.
Bend down, please, Jay. Robert.
Clueless?
That's correct, Stacy.
Clueless.
Correct, Jay.
Bye, y'all.
Bye, y'all.
All right, and,
clueless.
All right, and then last question here in the category.
I love how creative they get with their wrong answers.
Sci-fi. All
right.
Category of sci-fi. Okay. What is the name of Charlie Hunnam's character in Pacific Rim?
That's fucking Raleigh
Everybody
Bennett. Raleigh Beckett.
Yeah.
Raleigh Beckett.
People can actually name the character.
I fucking saw the movie like 2 weeks ago.
Five.
We watched it in 3D
four,
on my 3D television, man.
Three,
fucking love it.
Two.
Raleigh Beckett.
One,
we just got it on Blu-ray, I think.
Hunky Man. I don't know.
Hunky Man.
Who the hell watched that?
No.
Man, come on, Jay.
Incorrect.
Get the fuck out of here with that.
Bad actor.
Incorrect.
Well,
okay,
fuck.
Four.
And I love that movie.
Yo, come on,
right,
Burnett.
Because Jay Miss Jay Washington has been eliminated.
Damn.
All right.
Yeah, Jay, I'm sorry,
Draco,
bro. Sorry to see
Jay.
You go, bro.
And Draco, at 1 point,
he goes from 5-5 to 1. Now, hang on.
All right. Okay.
Anything can happen.
What was the correct answer?
Right,
the correct answer was Raleigh or Raleigh Beckett. Raleigh or Raleigh Beckett.
Sure.
All right.
Back.
I watched that like did 2 weeks ago.
All right.
Hey, me too.
Movie.
I fucking love that movie, dude.
Next competitor.
It's not the greatest movie ever made, but for its genre, it's fantastic.
He is number
31. Oh shit, you're Game of Thrones.
The Pit Boss.
What? Yo, what the fuck? Yo, we've been duped. We've been duped. Yo, look, he's got his lanyard on. Yo, what? Too bad that Game of Thrones question fucking missed him. Yo, let's go. Yo, Ken, I just watched you win, bro, at Soho Celebration. Nice.
The reason why he did not have a computer in front of him this entire time.
Yo,
he's been tricking everybody.
We've been had.
He is here to fight.
We've been had, y'all.
All right, guys. Brand new round. Brand new scoreboard. But not a brand new category. We go to directors.
All right.
Who directed Dead Poets Society?
Ooh. Oh, fuck.
Who starred Dead Poets Society, but can they get who directed it?
Andrego certainly did.
Is it Gus Van Sant?
Five.
No, he did Goodwill Hunting.
Four.
But he could have done this too.
Two. One. Ken.
Probably a white male.
You would be correct.
Brianne.
John Singleton.
No.
Draco.
Peter Weir.
Correct.
Robert.
Yo, Ken, with that answer, though.
That's correct. Stacey.
Nice. This says Peter Weir, but it looks like.
I know. We're not falling for that shit.
We cannot take that. In the category of classics.
Got to pass on that.
Walter Burns in the Howard Hawks classic, His Girl Friday.
Fuck.
Deep breaths up there at the table.
This is gonna be a big one.
What's that name? Right. His name? Rock Hudson?
Four.
Three, I think it's Rock Hudson. I don't know.
Two, one pence down.
Probably dead ass wrong.
Cary Grant.
That's correct for one point.
It's my face.
Cary Grant.
That's correct. Robert.
Fred McMurray.
Ooh.
Oh, Fred McMurray. My Three Sons. I see.
Kenny.
Can I get a Star Wars question?
All right. Here we go.
All right, folks.
You'll give him one, Sled.
Category. Of new releases.
All right.
Couldn't get the father. But who played the older brother in Sing Street?
Ooh, I think it's Jack Rayner. What not 100% fuck? Sure. I need to
Five,
finish that movie, but I think it's Jack Rayner.
Four, three, two, one. Pens down. And Mark Andrego.
Fuck you.
The really cool dude.
I thought your screen junkies loved that movie, man. Hunky Men.
His name is on the soundtrack, which I own, and I can't remember it.
Oh, no! Come on, Ken.
No one I know.
All right, we're looking for Jack Rayner.
Yeah. Ah, good shit.
All right,
good
look
shit.
At that, okay?
You're the only ones.
Jack Rayner. Question number four.
Damn.
Category of biopics.
All right, here we go.
Corey Hawkins played whom in Straight Outta Compton?
Dr. Motherfucking
Corey
Dre.
Hawkins played whom
we now know him
in
as
Straight Outta Compton?
Black Bauer.
Five.
Jack Bauer is black, man. Jack
three,
is black.
Two, one. And Robert.
Dr. Dre?
That is correct.
That is correct.
Easy E.
That's incorrect.
Oh, you would just swing and a miss.
Dr. Dre.
That's yo, correct. Yo, Ken, yeah. Straight out of Compton? I did not know this.
Two, man, two, two. Okay.
Strike
so
it out.
Now, our final question in this round.
Oh, no.
Woo!
Final question.
It's been fun, you guys.
Your homegirl
all right.
did not get a question.
Here we go,
so far?
Folks. Your
all
final right. question of this round comes
come on, Ken,
from
skip
the category.
One more. That's all you
sure
need,
you'll
brother.
Be happy
that's all you need.
Of musicals.
Yes. Ooh. Yeah, the ladies usually know these.
Who played
these two ladies? I should say.
Who played the Baker in 2014's Into the Woods?
Ooh. Oh.
Now this comes down to a factor where. This could be very interesting.
This is where being
the
gay
trailer.
Comes in real handy.
No kidding.
Five.
No kidding.
Four.
James
three,
Corden, I think.
Two. One.
Because I know he was
down.
In the movie,
Stacey.
But I don't know if the Baker was.
Corden,
that's correct.
Okay.
Ten.
I got one.
Wait, actually, you know what? Hold a second. Can you show that board? Say it again.
Yeah. James Corden.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
No,
it's
Corden.
That is incorrect.
Corden.
All right, Ken.
This was really fun, guys. It was really fun.
It's still going to be around. Don't worry.
Didn't see it with hearts.
James Corden.
Thank you.
Correct.
Thank you, Mark.
Robert?
Didn't know.
All right.
I mean, you're still in there, bud. You're still in there, baby. I see.
Eliminated.
Gotta go. Sorry, Jessica.
Ken is still sticking around. She lasted a number of rounds.
She did.
We had two members of 6 Degrees in there for a few rounds.
50% of the team left.
Our next contestant,
no John Snap?
Number 32.
No Snap, man.
Making his Schmodown debut.
Uh-oh.
Representing
who is
Collider.
It?
He is Dennis Zell!
Yo, D?
Dennis
Yo, Big D, I see you. Yeah! Yo, Joe, the modest assassin! His singles debut, he's never been in singles, but he has been in teams way back in the day. Yo, Big D is in the building. I see you. Got his aviators on.
Talk about diversity, right?
All right, here
we go. Wakanda is here. Let's go.
Hitchcock films.
Oh, shit. We're going off and running.
Roger Thornhill in Hitchcock's espionage mystery, North by Northwest?
That is Cary Grant all day. Roger Thornhill is the main character of North by Northwest. If he is, that's Cary Grant.
Anybody's match. Five.
Definitely not
four,
Jimmy Stewart.
Three, two, one. Ken.
Cary Grant?
That's correct.
Thank you, bro.
Jimmy Stewart.
Incorrect.
Ken is fighting.
Cary Grant.
Correct. Robert.
Fighting first.
Cary Grant.
Correct. Dennis.
Cary Grant.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Dennis. Woo! His first point off the board. Okay.
Dennis in the building. Good shit. All Never right. seen a play by himself.
Your next category comes to us in the form of Julia Roberts. In My Best Friend's Wedding, where does Julianne find Kimmy hiding after she sees her kissing Michael?
Okay.
One of only four films to ever make me cry.
Is that true?
Not a lie. Wow. It's actually
I'm going
to
say in the bathroom. I've never seen this movie.
Three.
Never seen this fucking
two,
movie.
Two, one. Pens down. Brienne.
Bathroom?
That is correct.
There you go. Mark. That's what's up.
Bathroom at the stadium?
I guess some of these questions. I've been Googling some of these closet. Fucking questions.
Correct. Dennis.
Nah.
Never seen it.
Dennis.
I'm not seeing
that's correct. Ken.
I said church.
Oh, wow.
Oh, damn.
Okay. All right.
Dennis now.
Maybe the church
two.
Bathroom, Ken.
All right, here we go. Category number
that's
three.
That's the kind of movie, Ken.
Coming
you love rom coms.
Coming of age.
From
films.
90s. From the 90s.
Could you repeat the category?
Coming of age.
Thank you.
In the coming of age category, what classic comedy follows the academic and romantic pursuits of teenagers Stacey Hamilton, Mike Damone, and Mark Ratner?
It's not American Pie.
The crowd, obviously, thinking they know this one. And five, four.
It's not Ferris Bueller.
Three, two, one. Pens down. And
it's probably not
Fast Breakfast Times
Club.
At Ridgemont High.
That's correct.
Oh,
Robert.
Fuck.
Robert.
Fast Times at Ridgemont
High. I didn't find any of those names familiar.
16 Candles.
Oh.
Right. I actually haven't matured yet, so Weird Science.
And
Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
That was a big point for State.
Bits and pieces of my creation, Ken.
Okay,
is it real?
Next category.
All right, folks, your next category is that of classics. What actor appeared in the film Pillow Talk with Doris Day and Showdown with Dean Martin?
Oh, shit.
So crazy. And Draco was at one point almost out, but Ricky couldn't get rid of him.
No, he was able to hang in there.
Five.
Damn it.
Four.
I'm
skating.
Three.
All right, I'll reread the
Did
question.
Did you say Dean Martin?
I'll reread the question.
I don't know.
You got 5 seconds. Right quick.
What actor appeared in Pillow Talk with Doris Day and Showdown
That's
with Dean
Martin?
That's
a wide swath of time.
Five, four, three, two,
I don't fucking know, man.
One. And Drake.
Rock Hudson?
Correct.
Hey, get the fuck out of here!
Okay, Robert.
I was...
Right, yes. Dennis.
Man.
Humphrey Bogart.
Nope.
Ken.
That was
I
early.
Know the name Montgomery Clift.
I do too, bro.
I said Lee Marvin.
All right, so there you
All
go.
All good
Draco
answers.
Now.
Except for the
final
one.
Question here. In the category of horror. Category
oh, come on,
of
Dennis,
horror,
get one more, man. Come on.
Ken needs to hit
I
this.
Need you
if Ken hits
there.
This and Brianne, Robert, and Dennis miss, then they'll all be eliminated.
Dennis, you got this,
go.
Man.
Horror.
Hang in there, my
here
brother.
Here we go.
You too.
Who was the first female monster
you, Captain?
To appear in a movie?
That would be.
Who was the first female monster to
Bride
appear
of Frankenstein.
In a movie?
It's Bride of Frankenstein, man. Mm. I can't think of anybody else that
it's
came sooner.
Female Gremlin from Gremlins 2. Four, three.
Fortunately,
two,
not
one. Dennis.
Bride of Frankenstein.
That's correct.
Thank you, bro.
Ten.
That's what I'm talking.
Bride
about.
Of Frankenstein.
Woo! Yes.
Brianne.
Medusa.
Incorrect.
Damn.
Mark, sorry.
Bride of Frankenstein.
That's correct. And
yes,
Robert.
Sir.
Elsa Lancaster is the Bride of Frankenstein.
Oh shit! This man gave a government
All right,
name.
So after that, Ken Knapsack and Brianne have
Damn.
Been eliminated.
Damn.
Damn it, Ken. I'm sorry, bro.
Okay.
Brianne, shout out to Brianne too.
So we have has changed
Damn,
again.
Son.
Yes, we only have three competitors left.
Damn.
Three competitors
I know
left
Hector's
right
left.
Now.
I can't,
and two of them
and
are
possibly
out.
Scott Mance.
Right now, number
I don't know if Scott Mance was available for this, though.
He
oh, this is Navarro.
The reigning
The song's still the shit, though.
Geekdom champion from Hyper RPG
Just dig that bass line.
Do, do, do. Hector, do, do. The
oh, Jesus, that belt is way too big for you, bro. What is this, Attack on Titan? Boo him! Boo him! Boo this man! Boo this man! Quickly wash him out of the competition, please. Boo him!
34.
Oh, shit.
He is the Inglorious One, Sam Levy.
This guy's been seen as like the second coming of trivia fucking champions, but never delivers. Ever.
Scary. An advantageous draw for him.
What happened to my PlayStation 4?
Number for Sam.
I'll tell you what.
Look, I just like to say I'm at a handicap. I feel bad about what's happening here. I don't know if I can perform. It's really hard.
You have to toughen up. No, Burnett, man, I see you.
Really?
I know you're heartbroken. Don't worry, man. You're going to get that belt back, bro. I believe in you.
We start in the
category. You got to beat Jeremy. You got to beat this guy.
Harvey is about Elwood P. Dowd, who has a deep and heartfelt friendship with Harvey, a giant invisible what?
Man, trivia, as I guess it's movie trivia, is all about what you've been exposed to.
Yeah, so, yeah, when
and with that, you know,
it's really easy to moan out loud.
It's a crapshoot on what you know, but it's a giant invisible rabbit.
One,
that's
pen down,
the
please,
is.
Hector and Sam.
Be a rabbit.
Thank
that's
you.
Correct.
That's correct. Hector.
Rabbit.
Correct.
Oh, nice. Correct. Nice to see you.
Invisible rabbit.
Correct.
A little artistic flair.
A rabbit.
And Dennis.
Oh. Rabbit.
All right, there you go. So clean sweep. Full table here all at once.
Everybody came to play, man. Everybody came to play.
Next category in the category of 90s films. Who declares, I never take off my skates, in which 1997 film?
Yo, Heather Graham's Roller Girl.
That's not the movie title, but the first.
Who declares?
Roller Girl, man.
And that is.
She was super sexy in that, I got to say.
Four. Three,
a little crush on two, Heather Graham.
One. All right, pens down, say. Hector.
Yes, sir.
What do you got?
What you got for me?
Barrymore. Drew Barrymore.
Incorrect.
No. Character.
Roller Girl in Boogie Nights?
That's thank correct. You. Robert.
Roller Girl in Boogie Nights.
That's yeah. correct. Dennis.
Didn't have it.
Sam. Oh, no.
Roller Girl.
Well, here you go.
Fuck.
Okay, right. So right now, Sam Levine, Robert Meyer.
Come on, Dennis, you can bounce back,
Draco,
baby.
All tied up. And
I'm going to cry if fucking Sam wins this.
All right, guys, your next category comes to us in the form of 80s films.
I'm going
to
cry.
What
like a bitch
does Danny win in Caddyshack?
Oh, man. Oh. That's the Cardinal cinema. I have not seen Caddyshack. I've only seen.
To be specific, we're looking for the name of the tournament, not the sport.
Show and I've been meaning to watch it for not anime movie night.
Guys just changed their answers.
Just never got around to it. Damn. Right. It's got a lot of fucking greats in that movie, too.
Four. Three. Two,
I love me some Ted Knight.
One. All right,
I'm
going to
just
Andrea.
Tell you. I love me some Mary Tyler Moore Show.
All right, Robert.
The Bushwood Caddy Championship?
No, that's incorrect.
Incorrect.
That right, sounded Dennis. Legit.
No, I didn't have it.
Sam.
Damn.
Suck it, Trebek.
Oh, nobody knew.
Spring Wake.
What do you got?
No, we were looking for the Caddy Day Tournament.
Oh. Caddy Day Tournament.
Of course.
Caddy right. was in the title.
Question number
can Burnett
four.
Get half a point?
Action Adventure in Demolition Man. Where does Simon Phoenix find a laser gun?
Wow. Oh. Yeah. I love this movie.
Yeah, it's a good question.
I don't. Wow. Oh, police
five,
station?
Four. Three.
I haven't two, seen a movie. Well, it was the other day.
San Diego?
It's incorrect, Dennis.
No. Factory?
Incorrect, Sam.
Maybe a museum.
That's correct for 1 point.
Oh!
Radio Shack.
Incorrect. Nope. And Mark.
Taco Bell.
Incorrect.
Nice fucking guess.
Very
in the words of Simon Phoenix.
Good memory.
All right, here we go.
All right,
he's
folks,
performing. I can't fucking deny that.
The final question of this round comes in the form of Pixar film.
Woo!
I'm so glad I'm safe.
Yeah. This man don't know animation
name
for shit.
Three of the five emotions from Pixar's Inside Out.
Anger.
Name three
joy,
of the five emotions from Pixar's
sadness,
Inside Out.
Envy. Well, anger, joy, sadness.
Nope.
Fear.
Right. Five.
And
four,
disgust. They're all
three,
five.
Two, one. Dennis.
Anger, fear, sadness.
That's correct. Sam.
I went with sad, happy, and horny.
No. Hector.
Yep.
Just threw that away.
Anger, fear, joy, sadness, disgust.
And Draco.
We'll take that.
This shit.
Anger, sad, and happy.
Oh, incorrect. All
incorrect.
Right. And Robert.
Sad, depressed, and happy.
No. Incorrect.
Enjoy.
Correct.
Joy right, is what you're looking for.
Oh my God.
What? Man, fuck that! God damn! So there's only two people left.
To the finals against number 35. It is Sam Levine against number 35.
Oh come on! The fuck is this? Yo, is that Jeff? Jeff,
you. So it comes down to this. Sam Levine
bullshit.
Has knocked out everyone on the table. He is by himself.
What is
number
this randomness?
35 is about to come out. Oh. They will have a best of five. Whoever wins the best of five,
yo,
is
just went right to the fucking finals.
And can challenge for any championship.
Man,
of
bullshit.
Their choosing.
Please tell me it's Scott.
And now, introducing Please. Number 35, representing.
Who is it? GT?
Tom,
yeah, fuck y'all! Fuck y'all! This is rigged! What is this? Get the fuck! That's a dope ass theme song though, I'm not gonna lie. The fuck is this? What?
Number 35.
How in the fuck did that happen?
Four competitors got knocked out at once because Levine knocked everybody out.
He doesn't have to face anyone else.
He just walks into the final
and just faces.
He just strolls in.
Let me just point out how fucking amazing it would be, or will be, when Tom wins this thing.
That's nothing but animation questions, please.
And one winner.
Here we go.
Christian. Christian, what the fuck?
And the category of Star Trek. What is the alphanumeric designation?
He don't know this
written
shit.
On the outer hull of the USS Enterprise.
Oh my god, yo, Burnett must be kicking himself.
And
1701.
Right now, Robert Meyer Burnett 1701. Is crying somewhere. Yeah. He's not
I don't think Sam knows this either. He don't know sci-fi. If he knows this shit, which is one of the easiest things to know about Star Trek. Period. 1701.
Sam.
XVII?
Man, get the fuck.
Tom.
VII?
Incorrect. Robert, what's the answer? Scream it.
NCC 1701.
There it is. All right. All right. Go ahead.
I neglected to say NCC, but it's alphanumeric. Yeah.
I missed the first one.
Yo, Burnett must be kicking himself.
All right, guys. Question number two.
How these questions be dodging the rightful owners?
From the category of crime films.
Oh.
What crime film?
Let's go, Finstock.
I always tell the truth, even when I lie.
Oh shit.
Taking a moment.
What's the truth?
Sam.
Is that Kaiser Sose?
I'm a little confused.
Five, it's Kaiser Sose.
Four, three, two, one.
I'm pretty sure it's Kaiser Sose. I'm probably wrong.
Party? Incorrect.
I was going for Public Enemies, but that's not it.
No, we were looking for Scarface.
Oh, wow, right on that. That is so still as definitely. Oh, wow.
Castor Gomez and the Diaz brothers. All
right. Category
have you seen that movie? Well, I've seen it too. I can't fucking talk.
This is how this is supposed to end.
Category of 90s.
This is insane.
For what movie did Jack Palance win the best supporting actor for in 1991?
Oh, my God. It's
1991.
Oh, fucking City Slickers.
Video count?
City Slickers, bro. Come on. I've never rooted for Finstock so much in my life.
All right. Five.
Finstock, please.
Three.
City Slickers, bro.
City Slickers.
That's correct for one.
Please
point.
Get this.
That's correct.
Woo! I see. See you, Tom. Let's go. Let's go.
Just another pretty face with amazing chest definition.
In what could be the second final question of this entire match,
Woo.
A popular movie musical directed by John Huston was released in 1982.
Oh. Oh, fuck.
Five. Four. Three.
Fuck. Two, Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Correct.
Incorrect,
Sam.
Annie?
That's correct.
That's what it is.
All right, this could be it.
Wow.
Down to this.
Tom, please get this.
Sam Levine
misses.
This question, he will win.
Tom.
Here we go.
Tom, please.
And your category is comedy.
Thank you.
In what film do Luke Wilson and Maya Rudolph awaken after 500 years from a hibernation experiment?
Idiocracy, and Sam already knows it.
Now, Tom must get
He's
this.
He's got to hit it, and
it's
Sam's
Idiocracy.
Got it.
If Sam answers it, regardless of what Tam does, Sam wins the match.
In what film do Luke Wilson and Maya Rudolph awaken after 500 years from a hibernation experiment? Five. Four.
Fuck!
Three.
It's two, Idiocracy, man.
Tom.
Tom, please. It doesn't matter if he gets it or not, because Sam's got this.
It is happening today. Idiocracy!
It is happening today.
The winner of the 2017
I feel violated.
The Inglorious One!
Man, bullshit!
Sam, the any team.
Oh my God.
He can get a title shot of anything he wants, and we'll find out.
I'm so sad.
From behind the scenes, exactly what that's going to be.
Sadness.
We're just waiting on Sam. We're waiting on the. Has anybody seen where Sam?
Oh, I almost won this thing, obviously.
You see that? You were 35 and you were terrible.
Hey, it's a luck of the draw, right?
Damn.
What's that got to do anything?
Yeah. Oh, if this is a preview of the Bakuga match.
Jeff Snyder won like five rounds in a row. And then Andrejko knocked out all the so-called big beasts in this goddamn thing.
Yo, man, shout outs to John, though.
Sam Levine.
Almost
John bummers the stage and was in there forever.
Term. I don't think
shout
that
outs to John from
happened.
Real Rejects,
yeah, but look
though.
At the joke of the Four Horsemen. Bibiani, done. Matt Nost, or the pizza guy, whatever his name is. Done.
Hey, so is your boy. Your boy Jeff didn't make it three rounds.
Blip on the radar.
Maybe four.
That being said, you see what Andrejko can do. He deserves a title shot eventually to knock out that kind of table over there. It was unbelievable. Bibiani, the other guy, all those old guys who know a lot of movies. That being said, congrats to Sam Levine. He knew.
Here, the homie just walk up.
Any question? And that's,
scoop
that's
the scoop the mic.
There was 34 competitors and there was only one winner. Sam Levine won. Uh-huh. Bottom line. Is,
bottom line.
Everybody else is a loser.
Yourself included.
But other than that.
Also including you because you lost, Tom.
Big time. You could have won.
I'm here with John Humphrey of
Hell
the
yeah,
Rejects.
Dude.
Who
easily
had
the MVP,
a really
man.
Long run today here.
Yeah,
I didn't expect that. That was cool.
This should be a second prize for that.
Cinderella man. You just came out of nowhere.
That's actually, I watched that movie six times this morning.
Oh, that was how you, you got
yourself
pumped
up.
And then I dragged a log up this snowy mountain like in Rocky IV.
There you go.
That's basically my preparation.
That's a routine, babe.
All right. Now, how were you feeling as you found yourself getting further and further in this competition and just competitor after competitor came out there?
It just got more and more surreal to me. So it got more fun as it went along.
Okay.
I just started having a fun time doodling and you know.
Yeah. I mean, you have this nice magical horse with you. Is that Robert Meyer Burnett's horse?
This is Robert Meyer Burnett's horse.
Oh, Jesus.
Passion Fire, right? Passion Fire.
Passion Fire.
That's why.
I was
going to
say, do you think
but
that
you're,
the magical
you're on the Young
horse
Bucks, man.
You
why are you fraternizing with the enemy?
I got to admit, she was whispering in my ear the whole time. Basically.
Oh, cheating.
Wow. Does she have a direct line
cheating
to
confirmed.
Robert Meyer Burnett?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay, some might consider that cheating, but it's so brilliant that I'll let you get away with it. Now, was there any competitor that came out that you were nervous was going to knock you out that you managed to defeat? Or is it all kind of a blur?
I don't think I defeated anybody. I was super, I don't know, I thought everybody was going to wipe the floor with me. So, Mark Riley, definitely.
Yeah.
And I was terrified just to watch John Rocha and Dan Merle combat, but just to hang out for a few rounds with those guys was tremendous.
Well, it was a tremendous showing on your part today, John.
You
and
did
we
great,
hope
bro.
To see you in the singles competition sometime
this guy.
Soon.
Yeah. I want to see him in singles, man. I hope
he
definitely jumps on that.
Mark Andrejko, what a knockout. Yeah. Holy moly.
That was pretty nuts.
No one was more surprised than me.
Another four-way murder.
Four people with the same score and then me with a different one. I'm like, oh, I guess I'm out. And then everybody started screaming. I was like, oh, holy crap.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, wow.
My different score is better.
So you're welcome, Sam. You're welcome, Sam Levine.
I mean,
man.
You
went out just the way you came in, bro.
Not a Lord of the Rings question in sight.
I know.
Your loss was bookended.
There was a Star Wars question, but it didn't matter, so yeah.
Yeah. What were your thoughts when you came out to that table full of some of the top competitors in this league?
I just hope they didn't get a goose egg because they're all so great combined. You know, they've won probably everything at this match.
I think everybody got a point, really.
So to actually win.
If anybody went through and didn't get a point, that sucks.
Yeah,
sucks for you.
That's definitely the only good thing.
Even Finstock got a point,
literally
goddammit.
Anybody yeah. alive. So I think everybody was really looking forward to a nice performance on the part of everybody that was there. And it was so great to see you come out on top because you've been one of the toughest competitors in this
yeah,
league.
Mark pulled off the play of the game. That's all I know.
As many wins as somebody like Bibiani or Merle or Rocha. So how are you feeling
not even,
right
not
now?
Even
you
know, Sam's was as good as Mark's
gone
was.
Further. I would have loved to have gone up against Sam because Sam's such a great competitor.
Yeah.
But, I was in there for four rounds, I think. So
yeah.
Four rounds, you know. There's nothing to be ashamed of, and I guess
some of the toughest rounds.
Telling me that people are going to be talking about the four knockouts there more than anything else. So I'm a footnote in history.
Yeah, I think you're now a pretty significant.
I'm sure they'll do another one of these. I hope so.
History. Well,
should do this twice a year.
Thank you very much.
Again, Mark Andrejko, wonderful job today, and I am.
I love
sure
these Schmodown events, man.
In the Schmodown very soon.
I wonder what they got
planned.
Collider collision, right?
The Beast.
Then that's what's next.
Growl, growl.
Oh, sans jumpsuit.
Yeah, you know, it gets a little, it cleaned up. Bloody, gets a little sticky after a while, and I like, funky. I like to kick my feet up after a match, enjoy a nice cold iced tea.
I'm not delicious. Oh yeah,
I saw what it did to do.
Inside of fava beans, man.
Don't drink in trivia. Don't drink in trivia.
Now you were at quite the table today, sir, if
How
I may
awesome
say so.
Was that table?
It was incredible.
That was great. That was like I'm not even mad I lost at that one.
It was a murderer's row.
Like every one of like the top players in the game had a seat at that table, and even when Andreyko came out, I'm just like, yeah, you can't miss one question.
Yeah.
It's a table of high rollers, man.
No room for error at all.
It's definitely the highlight of the fucking night, man.
I'm happy to be a part of a really cool moment.
Yeah.
I honestly am. And what I like about that in particular is that none of those people can claim that they're better than me right now.
Yeah.
So I still get a chance to destroy them in the singles, and I don't think I'll be handicapped in any way. So I'll get them all eventually.
That is
eventually.
Absolutely true. It was really anybody's game with all of the people that were at the table with you. But Bjorn, he some holes in his game. Who knew the
and
question?
This kind of showed it. This kind of showed everybody's weakness, though.
Co-directed that movie with
I'm
kind of
shocked that Scott
Manson
didn't make it, and Jimmy Johns wasn't in this.
That's on me.
That's
I
okay.
guess.
That's
I guess
okay,
he's just
going to
stick
with
the Geekdom Intergeekdom Championship.
Than
I guess
the average Joe would ever possibly answer in any movie or trivia contest ever.
I think my run was canceled too soon.
Plug.
Oh Lord. Oh Lord.
Please listen. That's all I got. This was a lot of fun, and I certainly hope to be doing it again and again.
Well, great showing again today, Bibbs, and we look forward to seeing all of your work in the singles matches in the near future.
Remember, pop collars are coming back. Growl, growl.
All right, we are here wrapping up the
Yo,
results
Merle
of the Schmodown
actually, I think, lasted the second longest, I think.
Movie Trivia Schmodown.
I don't know how many rounds he has lasted,
Merle,
but
Dan,
I got to listen to the,
really good
the Schmodown today. Rundown
you know,
to find
I had
out.
Hopes of winning the whole thing, challenging Roka directly. Maybe even, who knows, if I could have done it even before he gets a chance to fight for it again. But
at least you didn't
out.
Lose
I mean,
to him,
that
though.
That just goes to show you that's the nature of the game. You can do everything right, and if it's one question and you don't know it, you're gone.
It's true, especially with the table
showing,
that you
Dan.
Found yourself.
That was
all
a murderer's row. You know,
yes,
I know
sir.
That,
thank you.
And singles
thank you,
in
sir.
Singles play that we're all set against each other. I feel like we went through something.
I gotta
together
watch Dan's
today.
Labyrinth, man. I gotta get caught up.
I'm gonna take it easy on any of them, and it doesn't mean that I give them any credit. But it does mean that we went through something today, and you know, I'm
you'll share
something
special, bro.
I think I made a respectable showing. I was up there for a while, and so you know, no regrets today. I just, except for the regret of not winning.
I
wish I could have been there to face
Merle,
Levine
you got
and everyone else.
Nothing to be ashamed of today.
Yeah.
Excellent, excellently played
you did
game
your best,
today,
bro.
Sir.
Yeah.
And I'm sure we'll see you in future Schmodowns.
Yeah, and I'm gonna call Dagnino next time and leave him a message that he says I've been leaving him just laughing because that's what happened. That was pitiful. That was pathetic. The floor got wiped with you, my friend. That was pathetic.
We got it back.
Right,
you're just shadow
little
look, look at Roka laughing.
Champ, but not the champ of the free for all, John Roka.
Yep.
Oh man,
the belt couldn't quite buoy you into victory today.
No, I mean, he still got the belt though, man.
Way longer than probably most people thought I would. Almost 10 rounds or around 10 rounds.
Nice.
And I hung in with some of the heavyweights of this tournament.
Yeah, you only
so
got you got bodied on technicality, bro.
Bibiani or McQueeny or Andreyko or any of these fools.
What was Andreyko
better than me? We played toe to toe, and we. I don't want to hear it anymore. I don't want to see it on Twitter. I don't want to see it on YouTube. I don't see any of this crap on Facebook pages.
You tell them.
I'm just as good as them.
You body them
like
shits.
Like it or not.
That's what I'm talking about. You got the
he
strap, bro.
By Andreyko, but fair. He came in at the right time.
I mean, with that logic, you think Finstock is a better competitor than me.
But I don't know, right?
I
do not think that. Also, there's no such person as Finstock anymore.
Yo, Christian. Tom Dagnino. They dragged him up off the back of some bar somewhere. They woke him up, put some water on him, and threw him in here. And look what he did. He missed almost every question. It's a joke that he was 35. He almost had his grubby homeless hands on my pristine belt, and that's ridiculous. I can't have it. Sam Levine, what do you answer? Like 2 questions out of 5? Good job, Chief. But now he's got to face a real challenger, a real competitor for the title. All right?
Oh,
I'll take
no.
care of Riley in 5 rounds. Then I take care of Sam, and then I'm done with this crap, and you bring me a real competitor for this belt. Not someone who can't handle animated films and family films. Someone who's well-rounded. That's what I want.
So you think Sam's coming after you, then?
No, he called the belt.
That's what I'm assuming. Unless he wants another belt, why wouldn't you want the top belt in the league? Nobody gives a crap about
that. Definitely
the going
to Inner Geekdom.
And the Inner Geekdom's number 3.
He's not going
this
after
is
teams.
The number 1 belt. This means you're the face of the league, and I am the face of the league.
And Roka would easily body his
Sam
shit.
Levine?
I don't want to challenge Sam Levine. Is Sam Levine challenging? I don't know. You were talking to him, Emma. You're the reporter. You tell me.
I know Levine has
I'm
got
just
more
just
holes in his game than fucking Roka does. That's
Did
for
he
sure.
challenge me or not?
I'm not trying to be a fanboy.
You
I'm just saying, just based on the categories that
he
can answer versus what
right. Thank you, Emma.
Levine
yeah,
can answer. It's
well,
John Roca, good showing today. I have to say, it's a whole lot less trivia. There's a reason that you're the champ.
Yeah, in all honesty, but it was a heck of a fight. Like
the wheel will fuck people over, though.
It was great to go toe to toe with those guys, and for me, I'm even more confident in the knowledge I have.
From now on, everybody,
when you hashtag Outlaw Nation, when you hashtag the Outlaw, use capital letters, because that's what we're doing now.
Capital letters makes everything more important.
Congrats again on a good showing today, John Roca.
Thank you, Emma.
I will represent, bro.
We will look forward to seeing whether or not Sam Levine challenges you in the near future.
The champ is still here.
That's right, in the building.
Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, the Movie Trivia Schmodown free-for-all champion, the inglorious one,
had to put
Sam
in work today.
Levine.
Thank you so much. I know what people are going to say. They're going to say, oh, you got lucky because he came in the later rounds. And you know what? I absolutely did.
You did.
But there's a lot of luck involved in all of these. And for all this shit bad luck that I have had to put up with the fucking wheel, with picking the wrong numbers in round three, I get lucky once and draw number 34.
What's my ass?
I don't want to hear...
You've won matches.
Luck.
Get the fuck out of here.
This was definitely a good showing of how luck and skill come together. Ooh. Because certainly you won this competition.
Man, he's
going to
challenge Roca after his fucking match
with
Riley. Is what's
going to
happen.
I do not believe I was the strongest
competitor
in the free-for-all
today. Roca's having to go twice over. That's
going to
suck.
I just got a lucky draw with my number, and then the first round that I had was,
hopefully,
I guess, the
hopefully Roca won't run any problems
with
Riley. I mean, Riley's going
to
be a tough match already.
And all of my opponents only got two, which was nuts. That, to me, was the real crux of the competition for me.
So well, despite the fact that you were feeling very lucky right now, is there anything else you're feeling after winning this mega competition?
I'm feeling a few things. The first thing I want to say is I was sitting in the back of the room for the entirety of the competition.
No doubt.
Playing along, and I had witnesses. If I had been sitting there for the whole time, I would always show my answer to those sitting near me. So
wow.
I'm fairly confident I would have done reasonably well.
Oh, I'm sure you knew one answer about a fucking obscure ass film.
Is I don't know, maybe sort of a bloodlust to wipe the smug fucking smirk off of John Roca, who might not even be the champion still by the time I get my hands on him.
Oh,
but I want to wipe that smirk off his fucking arrogant face.
Right. So
I think this Friday we got a match. I think we got two
Roca,
matches going. I think Roca's going to win them both.
I want to take
Let's
on
not
the
fuck
champ.
Around.
I hope it's Riley because
he's going
a good person.
Getting that motherfucking ass.
A decent man who comes from a decent family and state.
Oh.
Doesn't wear a fucking cowboy hat. You're not a cowboy, Roca. You live in Los Angeles. Who do you think you are? The fucking
It's the home of the Wild West, bro.
With that nonsense.
You ever heard of Gold Rush?
So you're officially issuing a
Terrible,
challenge
bro.
To John Steven Roca then, because you can go after whoever you want.
I can. Well, I mean, I want to. Obviously, I would love a title shot.
Sure.
So, so whoever wins that title between Roca and Riley, I will gladly take them on. On a personal level, I guess I hope it's Riley because he's a decent, kind-hearted man. But on a competitor level, I kind of hope it's Roca because fuck you.
Oh shit!
I like you, Sam Levine. I think we can connect on that.
We got
point.
Some shit talking.
Well, congratulations again
on some,
your epic victory
some bullshit.
Today.
Right.
We look forward to seeing whoever it is champion
man,
that you face
that
off
Yang
with in the near
for
future.
Real.
Sam had his moment. Sam picked his title, and there we go. So when Sam wants it, all he's got to do is ask. Now it's up to you guys. You like what you watch today in this
Will
epic,
get it right
epic free-for-all comment.
Will he get it right then and there?
Make sure you do that. That's how
That's
we get
question.
To put on more shows
or will they
like
postpone
this.
It, to
it is
match.
Up to you guys to do that. I'd like to thank John Campia for joining me today. Ken Knapsack for joining and then leaving and then answering a few questions here and there. thank you guys so much. Join the Movie Trivia Schmodown Facebook page. You want to get involved?
Absolutely,
more, talk
man.
To fellow competitors, do that. Check out the Schmodown Rundown.
Facebook.com/group/Schmodown.
Here, do not forget the title.
And Schmodown Rundown. You guys can find
Mark
that on
Riley, next week. And for
the
John
Schmoes
Campia,
No podcast
I'm Chris
feed.
Charloff. See you next time.
Just look up Schmoes No on iTunes. You'll find it. Uh oh. Oh, we're running it back. I'm about to say, I thought we were going to have an addendum about a mistake being made. Thank God. Whew. The judges have been on point as of recently, man. No mistakes. At least not any major mistakes that would, like, cripple the match have been made, so that's cool. There's a lot to keep track of, too, when you watch this whole thing unfold. When you have five players going at the same time. Yo, look at all these people. They had a good run, man. Yo, Ellis made it. That's all I know. Yo, look at this guy.
Yo, Corey.
Not Hans Zimmer, sir. There he is. So when the tides turn, yo, shout out to Rachel. Oh yeah, that was when John had to leave. Yo, Bernardin! D. Griff. Yo, D. Griffey, man. Yo, Murrow was a machine too. Yo, Nick was all right. Oh, Ricky came through. Yo, the killer right there. Yo, here we go. Empty chairs. Ta! There he goes. America's favorite big body. And then Jason. Yo, the captain, though. I was upset when they got dismissed again, man. Fuck! Oh. Yo, the memories. Hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah, Dennis. Dennis Thomas might have been short-lived. Yo, Hector got bodied all the same. Damn. Please. Real news. Yo, Finstock equals ratings, though. And it equals ratings again. Yo, where's Ashley? That's all I want to see. Let's round this out the proper way.
Hey guys,
there we go. Let's do it.
The thumbs up button. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Another fantastic episode of the Schmodown. Props to Harloff and the crew, man. That shit was fantastic, man. God damn. So yeah, man. None of my picks made it. Not a fucking one.
Not a fucking one.
I get to sit there and hold that L close to my chest, man. Oh well. Oh well. It is what it is. Sam Levine won. Now he has the chance to challenge, and it sounds like he's going to challenge the winner of Rocha versus Mark Riley. So we're going to see how that plays out. This Friday actually is when that happens. They have an undercard. I think it's Brienne versus God. Who is it? I forget who the opponent is. Oh, it's Brienne versus Perry Nemiroff. So that's what's happening this Friday. So another nice extended episode of the Schmodown, and I don't know if they're going to the challenge from, I guess, Sam Levine will probably be at a later date. Probably sometime soon, though, because they want to knock that out so they can get the natural progression. But who knows? It could happen at Collider Collision, so we'll see. But yeah, it's another great episode, man. I really enjoyed it. Props to everybody involved. And again, if you haven't done it, if you watched the episode but you didn't rate and comment on the actual original video, please, the link is down below. Go do that on both parts. And I'll see you next time for the next episode, which is Machinima ETC, or maybe they're just ETC now, Team ETC, versus, the Wolves of Steel. My favorite in that is the Wolves of Steel, but we'll get into that next episode. In the meantime, thanks again for watching the Schmodown Run Back with your boy Sobo Ryu. We'll see you on the flip side. Peace.